Argentina. They planned a contemplative trip, but ended up distracted by the mounds of rubbish floating in the river.
Seeing so many rivers, we spent the Ganga, thinking it's one of the most contaminated rivers, and like everyone was swimming, and we were like, we don't really want to watch it.
The Ganges is a main tourist attraction here, but the river is drowning under a sea of rubbish. Many visitors are troubled by what they see.
Can you put all the trash and guilty and dead bodies in the river?
According to this river taxi driver, there are around half the number of tourists there once were. Many are put off by the pollution. He took us.
All the wastewater from the city. It's one of the biggest drains in Varanasi. And there's another one just after the bridge. There are 36 in total, and they flow 24 hours a day.
200 million liters of untreated wastewater pour through the drains each day. The buildup of fecal waste and toxic material has killed all marine life. 450 million people live along the river, and the population goes up by 1 million each year. The result? Huge amounts of household trash. But ultimately, it's a political problem. Sanjay Sharma works for the city council. He organised a clean-up operation to take place while our cameras are rolling.
Why is that still there? Why? Clean that for me, right away.
His organisation has links to Narendra Modi. 4 years ago, the Prime Minister promised to clean up the river, but nothing's happened.
We saw the waste coming out of the drain over there. What is the government doing?
The government is dealing with the problem. We will close the drain and filter the water before putting it into the river.
Hypoxia and results in a chain reaction to the death of many fish in the ocean. Hypoxia first starts out the bottom feeding organisms known as phytoplankton because algae has covered the seabed. The zooplankton is then affected because now they don't have anything to eat. Spring until the fall, because in the fall, nitrogen loss is 36% greater than in the spring. We invest in perennial crops because they obtain nitrogen through the atmosphere by nitrogen fixation and thus do not require nitrogen fertilizer at all. Most farmers do not participate in these alternate methods because they fear loss of profit dollars and damage that taxpaying citizens will have to pay, including those farmers.
The river annually. In 2010, that amount increased to 33.9 billion tons, according to the Yangtze River Water Resources Protection Bureau. The bulk of the waste comes from factories along the river's middle and lower reaches. Environmentalist Yang Xin says authorities need to step up waste management to protect this major water resource.
The Yangtze River supports 400 million people and nearly half the country's economy. Each year, more waste is discharged into the river. We've continuously said that the river needs to be better protected, including improved oversight of waste management to lower the amount of discharge.
Chinese authorities say they've been closing down factories with poor waste management systems along.
Samuel and Dominique have traveled from Argentina. They planned a contemplative trip, but ended up distracted by the mounds of rubbish.
We mean that we're like, we don't really want to support our family.
The Ganges is a main tourist attraction here, but the river is drowning under a sea of rubbish. Many visitors are troubled by what they see.
They just put all the trash and dead bodies in the river.
According to this river taxi driver, there are around half the number of tourists there once were. Many are put off by the pollution. He took us to its source. The drain that leads into the river, only a few hundred meters away from the historic center of the town.
This is all the wastewater from the city. It's one of the biggest drains in Varanasi. And there's another one just after the bridge. There are 36 in total, and they flow 24 hours a day.
200 million liters of untreated wastewater pour through the drains each day. The buildup of fecal waste and toxic material has killed all marine life. 450 million people live along the river, and the population goes up by 1 million each year. trash. But ultimately, it's a political problem. Sanjay Sharma works for the city council. He organized a cleanup operation to take place while our cameras are rolling.
Why is that still there? Why? Clean that for me right away.
His organization has links to Narendra Modi. 4 years ago, the Prime Minister promised to clean up the river, but nothing's happened.
We saw the waste coming out of the drain over there. What is the government doing?
Thank you.